Me lords and ladies, boys and girls, welcome. Welcome as we celebrate the founding of Baysville. Yes, today is 150th anniversary. Citizens and visitors alike are so proud of Muskoka's breath of fresh air. Yes, the village of Baysville, founded by our forefathers in 1871. Imagine these magnificent lands, home of the First Nations, as settlers slowly progressed into the region to form this wonderful village that developed into a thriving destination for the loggers, fur trappers, and eventually tremendous tourism. So let's take a quick look at the past and the present as we wander through this picturesque, quaint, and yes, very charming settlement. Why don't we start right here at these docks along the mighty Muskoka River? Me lords and ladies, did you know that good old Hector McQuarrie once owned a sawmill right here by these docks? Yes, in 1902, very, very luckily, while the workers were away having lunch, the boiler and the smokestack that operated the sawmill suddenly exploded. Why, the boiler went clear across the river, putting a huge hole right through J.D. Smith's store, and finally landing on the side street far beyond. No one was hurt, but there it lay, right where it landed, far from these shores for over 40 years before it was finally sold as scrap for the war effort. Me lords and ladies, boys and girls, so here we are at Miss Nell's Antiques and Cafe, built in 1872 by Baysville's founder, Mr. William H. Brown. It later became Captain Marsh's Dry Goods Store, commencing in 1876. Captain G.F. Marsh sold it to Mr. Langmaid in the 1920s. Soon thereafter, Mr. Langmaid, a butcher, hired a wonderful 18-year-old girl, Miss Nels Conley, to operate his grocery section. Unbelievably, Nels actually inherited these premises from Mr. Langmaid as an outstanding thank you for her compassion while she had nursed him during his lengthy illness prior to death. Nels continued to run it as her own dry goods store until she was 86 years old. Now that's dedication. She went on to live a ripe old age of 103. Eventually, these premises became known as Langmaid's Cafe and Miss Nels Antiques, named after our legendary Miss Nels. She returned here for her 100th birthday. So come on in for a visit to a fabulous Baysville business, Miss Nels Antiques and Beautiful Cafe. Oh yay! Me lords and ladies, boys and girls, welcome to the oldest house in Baysville. It's truly a gem, owned by Shirley and Bob Burton, who for several years ran their bed and breakfast from right here. Shirley, the great-granddaughter of our village founder, Mr. Brown, was not only the fourth generation of Browns who lived in this Victorian edifice, but this family also had four generations acting as the Baysville postmasters. Yes, this was the first post office of Baysville, with the mail kept snugly in the sewing machine drawer in the dining room. Collectively, this family delivered the Baysville mail for an amazing 103 years. Please take notice that before you is the original front door, the original antique glass windows, and the converted 1872 coal oil lamps. So as we depart these premises, journey back in time and envision Shirley's father, Scotty, at early break of dawn, leaving here in a horse-drawn stagecoach, making his daily trek to and from Bracebridge, whether in storm, sun, sleet, or hail, to deliver the mail to picturesque Baysville. Me lords and ladies, welcome to the Mural House, another project built in 1896, and yes, you guessed it, by William H. Brown, Baysville's founder. These premises, like the Burton House, served as a post office until 1931. In 1952, artist Frank C. Johnson developed his artistic studio here while also operating a lithograph printing shop in his basement. You can witness Frank Johnston's creative artwork just over at the Senior Center. Today, I wish to mention our gratitude, nay, our outstanding and sincerest thanks for the heroic efforts of the Baysville and area firefighters who were able to save this historic building from the terrible flames that sadly consumed the famous Lincoln Lodge next door behind me on September the 10th, 2008. The only damage to the mural building? Just some melted siding. And now it's home to two apartments. Good citizens all, isn't this view fantastic? Just cast your eyes below to the Baysville Dam. Think of the tremendous energy created by the rushing waters of the mighty Muskoka River. Yes, this too was another project by good old William H. Brown, a true visionary. This was also the site of his sawmill, which utilized most of the complete riverbank. The first dam, built of wooden construction in 1873, was controlled by three sets of large stop logs that controlled the water's flow. The second dam, constructed in 1918, but with stone, was much better able to control the water levels. And with the water levels now raised 5 feet, it permitted lake steamers traffic into areas of Lake of Bays previously inaccessible. This magnificent third dam you now see today was a development created by the government of Ontario in 1960. Welcome back. So now, we've just arrived here at the Stone House, former site of Fenn Anderson's store, later to become Bill Telephone Office in 1947. These premises were unique because it was also the residence of Cecilia Armstrong, who became the Bill Chief Operator, along with her daughter, Marie, another Van Cleef, who jointly operated the Bell telephone services in this region for 14 years. The stone facade seen at the former doorway here, covered by the vines, successfully closed that entrance into a bygone era of communications within Baysville, with the departure of all the Bell equipment. Let's continue on now to Finley's. Oh yay, good citizens of Baysville and tourists alike. Lastly, my friends, this is the site of Finley's store, built in 1898 by a young man Bowerman who sold it to William Howard. In 1908, this store was sold again by T&H Richards, who had hired Billy Langmaid to manage the store, whereby it also became Billy's home. Eventually, however, Bill and Betty Finley traded a hotel business in Owen Sound with a friend to move here to Baysville. They commenced this Finley's General Store in 1957 until the year of Bill's death in the year of our Lord, 1968. Finley's daughter, Diane, still proudly resides in this village of Baysville within magical Muskoka. Oh, yay! Oh, yay! Oh, Canada! So now, this ends our little stroll of Muskoka memories in beautiful Baysville. I wish to mention that we extend our sincerest thanks to the young artist, 12-year-old Jonna Gauthier, who created Baysville's 150th anniversary logo. It's fantastic, and thank you. May God bless our village of Baysville and this great nation of Canada!